Hey, good morning, friends. It's Julie Hamilton. Yes, I'm a little earlier than usual. I'll tell you why in a minute. But I just want you to see, I brought you out here to see something beautiful. And guess what? The sun just came over the ridge. And I just want you to see this place. This is one of my favorite places to come when I need to get away and see something totally differently. And there's a bench up here, and I'm up at Alston Park. And as I'm sitting here on the bench the other day, you know, I'm looking out and I can see the green, the variations in the green vineyards that you see out there. And when that sun comes up, you're gonna see a row of trees that goes right along here. And there's so many variations of color in the trees. It's one of my favorite places. I'm just gonna move so you can see it again. But I mean, is that gorgeous or what? Look at the sun coming up over there. I mean, it's beautiful. But the funny thing is, when I left this place the other day, I was sitting up here looking at the gorgeous view, looking at the beautiful trees, looking at the vineyards. It is gorgeous. Crystal, you had to come. But when I got down and I started driving, and I was driving back to my house, I'm driving through this place, I'm dealing with stop signs, I'm dealing with pedestrians, I'm dealing with trees, and all of a sudden I realize I'm driving through this same spot right here that I love to look at. And it looks nothing like it does from this higher up perspective. And isn't that like life? Sometimes we get into the thick of whatever we're going through. Maybe we're suffering through something. Maybe we're going through it and all we see is tree trunks and stop signs and obstacles and people. And we're focused so much on just trying to drive through it, trying to make it through it. But there is a different view, and we don't know why we suffer sometimes. We don't know what the view is from above, but we're just trying to make it through where we're at, and we're not seeing the big picture. And so I wanted to encourage you today. I read something the other day. It was in Jesus Calling, and it said, every suffering has purpose in his kingdom. And I want to encourage you today, if you're in a situation that just looks horrible, you don't know how you're going to get out of it, you're hurting, you're aching, you're frustrated, you're going through all this, you're wondering, why is this happening to me? I want to remind you that there is a greater perspective, and there are probably some things that you are learning that are going to build in you maturity, that are going to build in you perseverance, that are going to build in you character. The trials grow your perseverance. The trials are for your testing. Your testing grows your perseverance, and your perseverance makes you mature and complete. And that's what we have to remember. Sometimes we just can't see the forest for the trees, or we can't see the vineyard for the vines, whatever it is, wherever you live. But I want to encourage you today to think about a higher perspective than where you're at. We're just maybe walking through the stop signs and all of that, but there is a bigger picture to what you're going through, and it's going to be great. Good morning, Abby. And here's the kicker, you guys. The bigger perspective might even be something beautiful. It might be something beautiful, and it feels really ugly where you're at and you're frustrated or whatever, but it's like, in the scope of your life, the thing that you're going through might even be something that looks incredibly beautiful, and you don't even know it yet because it's developing in you. So let that trial develop you. Let it work in you. Let it build in you character. Let it build in you perseverance, and don't give up, because things are really actually looking like this, even when you think they're not looking like this. So, good morning. Oh, good morning, Abby. I love you. I'm so proud of you. Oh, thank you, Crystal. I love you. Thanks for tuning in. But I did want to remind you guys about one more thing this weekend. Don't forget about the Walk for Freedom in San Francisco, walking from the San Francisco side of the Golden Gate Bridge across the Golden Gate Bridge to Marin. There are more slaves now than in the history of the world ever. And don't think that you just saw that news story where they rescued 130 kids somewhere out in the Midwest from slavery. And so it's time to get involved. Raise your voice with the Walk for Freedom. And you can do that on October 20th, and it's 11 to 12. no, 10 to 12. And just look it up. Walk for Freedom SF is where you look it up. Or Walk for Freedom San Francisco on Facebook. On Instagram, it's Walk for Freedom SF. I want to see you guys out there and get involved. So anyway, I love you so much. Thank you for tuning in with me this morning. I'm sorry I went live. It's because it's been crazy windy. And so I didn't want to come out. But then I looked at the weather and it was zero wind. So I was like, oh my gosh, we have to go right now. So, oh, good morning, Corinne. Oh, thank you for walking in Vacaville. Yeah, all across the country. Look up Walk for Freedom. There's probably a walk where you are. I know there's some in Dallas and Oklahoma. Also for Crystal, I know she's on. So anyway, you guys have a really blessed morning. And don't forget that your trials, your struggles, they actually can have a beautiful ending that looks something like this. And you might not even see it. Thanks for joining me this morning. Mwah. Go live your big, amazing, beautiful lives and have a great week. All right. Bye. Good morning, Veronica. Great to see you. Bye.